there are many roles that you have to keep shifting and playing. You just have to be really aware of what you're doing, be very conscious about it, right? And don't be afraid to ask for help. Don't have to be a perfectionist as well. And you don't have to be everything to everybody all the time. Because if you don't look after yourself, if you don't, you know, take the pause, you won't be able to be there for anyone. I'm personally, you know, delighted that, you know, we now have a very formal, structured approach, right, to flexibility in the workplace or flexible work arrangements in Experian.
For me, I have the flexibility of coming into the office at a time that is more convenient for me. And flex work actually gives us this benefit whereby we can manage our lives better. It's difficult to separate personal life and working life. So this helps us manage in a better way. And it gives the advantage, or it's more of it's a win-win situation for both sides.
With work-life integration being the buzzword, it's about time that organizations get really structured around this. My success, it depends really much on my team. With flex in place, one, I don't really need to be here at all times. At the same time, I can get complete information on what's happening at all times. So I know my team functions with or without me. I think it's completely inevitable. If managers embrace this and staff embrace the spirit behind it, companies can take off and, you know, everyone's going to be really, really pleased with the results.
If you look at our people today, 70% of our people are, you know, in that millennial group. If you show them that, you know, we are, you know, we trust you with flex work, then I think their engagement, right, and their stickiness with the organization will also increase.